Now, next topic is operations on large numbers, including conversion of units. So, how to convert the large numbers in smaller units, that we will learn. For example, for length. Now, see, for length, which are the conversion? So, for length, the conversions from centimeter to meter, or meter to kilometer, or kilometer to or millimeter to centimeter, like that it is there. First, see here, 1 centimeter is equal to 1 centimeter is equal to how many millimeters? CM means it is the abbreviation for centimeter. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. MM means millimeters. Okay. Next is 1 kilometer, 1 meter. Now meter, how to write? 1 m, m for meter. So 1 meter is equal to how many centimeters? 100 centimeter. 100 centimeters make 1 meter. Okay. And next is 1 kilometer. Kilometer. Now see, centimeter we are using to measure the what we can say, length of the pane, or smaller things are there to measure the length of those, we are using centimeter. Meter for what we are using? Suppose we want to measure the cloth, or we want to measure the length of the bed, for there we are using meter. Okay. And if kilometer, now kilometer for what we are using? For if long distances are there, then that we are using measuring by using kilometer. For example, the length of the road and all. Okay, so 1 kilometer is equal to how many meters? So that is 1,000 meters. Okay, in this way, suppose meters are there, then that also meter is given, then that we can convert into centimeter by multiplying it by 100. If centimeter is there, and that centimeter we can further convert into smaller unit, that is millimeter, by multiplying it by 10. And kilometers we can convert into meters by multiplying it by 1000. Similarly, opposite also we can do. From meter we can convert kilometer, from centimeter to meter, from millimeter to centimeter, but this time we have to divide. Okay. In this way we can do the conversion of units. Now conversion of unit for length we have learned. Okay, how to convert the units. Here for weight, now we will see the conversion of weight. See, 1 kg, kg means kilogram. 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. Okay, so if we want to convert kilograms into grams, we have to multiply the given number by 1000. Then whatever answer we will get, that will be the grams. Now next is 1 gram is equal to 100 centigram. Okay, 1 gram is equal to 100 centigram. And then 1 centigram is equal to 10 milligram. 1 centigram is equal to 10 milligram. So when we have to convert these bigger numbers into smaller, we have to multiply them by, here we have to multiply by the 1000. From gram to centigram, we have to multiply by 100. From centigram to milligram, if we want to convert, then we want to multiply it by 10. Same, when we want to convert the smaller numbers into biggers, then what we have to do? We have to divide it by, see, now from gram to kilogram, then divide it by 1000. From centigram to gram, we have to convert, then divide it by 100. And from milligram to centigram, we have to divide it by 10. See, now we will solve practice 1.3 based on conversion of units. In that, question number 1 is, make following conversions. First one, 11 kg to 50 grams to grams. Means this we have to convert into grams. See here, first of all, 11 kg means how many grams? 11 kg we have to convert into grams. 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. So 11 kg we have to multiply 11 by 1000. That is how many grams? 11,000 grams. Okay. 11 kg 250 grams are there. So in that, therefore, 11 kg 250 gram is equal to total how many grams we have to find out. So 11 kg means how many grams? 11,000. In that we have to add 250 grams more. So that will be 11,250 grams. Understood what we did? 11 kg 250 grams we have to convert into grams. So first we will convert kg into grams. Now how to convert that? So 11 kg is equal to, we have to multiply 11 by 1000. Why we have to multiply by 1000? Because 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. So 11 kg we have to multiply by 1000. That it will become 11,000 gram. Now in that 11,000 gram we have to add this 250 gram. And then we will get the final answer, that is 11,250. Now second question is 56,000 centigrams we have to convert into grams. Now see here, 1 gram is equal to 100 centigram, correct? So we have to convert now centigrams into grams, means from smaller to bigger we have to convert. That time what we have to do? That time we have to divide by the, now here centigrams is there, correct? And we have to convert into gram. We are knowing 1 centigram is equal to 100 grams. So, 1 gram is equal to 100 centigram. So, we have to here divide this centigrams by 100 to get grams. So, see here. First, I will write 1 gram is equal to 100 centigram. Okay. Therefore, 56,000 centigrams is equal to how many grams? So, we have to divide 56,000 by 100. We have to divide 56,000 by 100. That is, see, 100, 5 is a 500, 100, 6 is a 600 and 1 0. So we will get 560 grams. Okay, this is the answer. 100 centimeter, correct? So to convert 7 meters, 75 centimeters into centimeters, what we have to do? First we have to convert 7 meters into centimeters. So 7 meter is equal to 7 into 100. We have to multiply to convert meter into centimeter. We have to convert, we have to multiply it by 100. So 7 meter is equal to how many centimeters? 700 centimeter. And this 75 centimeters we have to add in that. Therefore 7 meter, 75 centimeter is equal to 700 plus 75, that is 775 centimeters. Now fourth is 25,000 grams we have to convert into kilograms. Now from smaller to bigger unit we have to convert. So when we are converting from smaller to bigger, we have to divide. Okay, means what? Now here, 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. Correct? Now we have to convert smaller to bigger. So we have to divide the given number by 1000. Therefore, 25,000 gram divided by 1000. What we will get? Answer. See, we can cancel these zeros also. Okay, this zero will get cancelled. This zero, and this. So what will remain? 25. That it will be kg. Okay. So this is the answer. Question number 2. To stitch a shirt, 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth is needed. Out of 38 meter 70 centimeter cloth, how many shirts can be stitched? Will there be any cloth left? So this we have to find out. Now, what is the meaning of these questions here? One shirt needed. How many cloth? How much cloth? 2 meter 15 centimeter. Now, 2 meter 15 centimeter, I will convert into centimeter. So, 2 meters means how many centimeter? 200 plus 15. That is 215 centimeter. Okay. And now, total, what is the length of cloth? Total length of cloth is equal to 38 meter 70 centimeter. That is 38 meter means 3800 centimeter. We have to multiply it by 100. 3800 plus 70. That is 3870 centimeter. This is the total length of the cloth. For one shirt need 215. So for how many shirts we can make from 3870 centimeter? So what we have to do? We have to do the division. Okay. Now we will divide 3870 by 215. That I will show you. Now see, we will divide 3870 by 215. See, 215 ones are 215. What will remain? 7 minus 5, 2. 8 minus 1, 7. And 3 minus 2, 1. Okay. Now, take this 0. Now, 215. We have to multiply by such a number that we will get 1720. Now, if I will multiply it by 8, then we will get 1720. See, 215 multiply by 8, 8 5s are 40, 0, carry 4, 8 1s are 8, plus 4, 12, carry 1, 8 2s are 16, plus 1, 70. So 215 8s are 1720. Okay. So how many shirts we can make? 18. Therefore, how to write final answer? How many shirts can be stitched? 18 such shirts can be stitched with this cloth. And next is, will there be any cloth left? Now see, what is the remainder? 0. So will there be any cloth left? No. So answer, how to write? 18 shirts can be stitched and no cloth will left. In this way, we will have to write the final answer. Next question. A Rudraksh weighs about 40 milligram. What will be the weight of a necklace consisting of 108 such Rudraksh? Okay. Means, weight of one Rudraksh is given. 40 milligram, and if in a necklace 108 Rudraksha is there, then what will be the weight of that necklace? Now see, first of all we will find out the weight of necklace by multiplying the weight of one Rudraksh with 108 such Rudraksh. So what is the weight of one Rudraksh? 40 milligram. And how many such Rudraksh are there? 108. So multiply 0 into 8, 0. 0 into 0, 0. 0 into 1, 0. Now unit place, we have to write compulsory 0. Now multiply 4 by 8. 4 8s are 32. So carry 3. 4 into 0, 0. Plus 3, 3. And 4 1s are 4. We have to add it. 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 2, 2. 0 plus 3, 3. And here 4. So answer will come in. These many milligrams. Okay. See here. Now 4320 milligrams. So we are knowing 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligrams. Okay. Then this we have to convert in grams. So what we have to do? We have to divide. Therefore 4320 divided by 1000. The answer will be, how to divide it? See here. You can do vertical division also. That is, see, 1000. Now 1000 fours are 4000. Okay, so 0, 2, 3, and 4. Now 320. Okay, so here no other place your digit is there. So put decimal and here write 0. Then we can divide. 1000 threes are 3000. Then again you have to take 0. After decimal, here we can go on taking 1111 place as a 0. So 1000 twos are 2000. So what will be the answer? 4.32 grams. In this way we have to do the division. Next question, fourth one. Onions were packed in sacks, each weighing 18 kg 500 gram. How many such sacks can be loaded in a truck with a carrying capacity of 3182 kilogram? Now see, in one sack this many onions are there, means 18 kg 500 gram, and the capacity of that truck is of 3182. So how many sacks we can load in that truck, that we have to find out. So what we have to do for that? For that we have to do the division, means we have to divide the total capacity of truck by the weight of one sack. Now here see, 18 kg 500 gram is given. So it is quite difficult to divide this number by 18.50, means 18 kg and 500 gram. For that what we will do? We will convert this 18 kg 500 grams into grams. So 18 kg means 18,000 grams, correct? Because 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. So 18 kg is equal to 18,000 and this 500. That is total 18,500 grams. And the capacity of truck also we will convert into grams. Now 3182 kg, this if we will multiply by 1000, we will get the answer in grams, that is these many grams. Now see, both are in same units, so we can divide it easily. So see here, this many grams divided by 18,500. Now what we will do? when such numerator and denominator zeros are there, no, then we can divide it. Okay, see here, we can cut it. Upper 1 0, 1 down 1 0, we can cut. Again this and this also we can cut. So what it remained? 31,820 divided by 185. So we can do vertical division also. Huh? 31,820. Now see, 185 ones are 185. Okay. 8 minus 5, 3. Now, can we subtract 8 from 1? So, what we have to do? We have to borrow 1 from 2, 3. Here 2 will remain, here 1 will be there. And here it will make 1, 1, 11. So, 11 minus 8 is 3. And 2 minus 1 is also, 2 minus 1 is 1. Now, this subtraction over, then take next digit down. Now, if you will multiply 185 by 7, then you will get 7 5s are 35, 5 carry 3, 7 8s are 56, plus 3, 59. That 9 you will write here, 5 we have to carry, 7 1s are 7, plus 5, 12. Now do subtraction of this. Again, can we subtract 5 from 2? No. So here 12. Here we have to borrow 1 from 3. 12 minus 5 is 7. And now we have to borrow 1 from 3. Here 12 will become, here 2 will remain. Now so 12 minus 9 is 3. And 8 minus 2 minus 2 is 0. This here also 0. Now remaining this 0 you will have to take down. It makes 370. Now 185 2s are, see 2 5s are 10, 0 carry 1. 2 8s are 16 plus 1 17 carry 1. 2 1s are 2 plus 3. So see now what is the answer? 172. So how many such sacks can be loaded in a truck? We can load 172 such sacks in